Source of spiritual maturity. Reading from Scripture, 2 Peter chapter 1 verses 2 and 3. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. As His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue. We are meditating on a new series of spiritual maturity and have already established that every believer needs to grow into spiritual maturity. As we read in today's scripture, growing in spiritual maturity comes only by the grace and the power of God. This means that God is our only resource to grow into spiritual maturity. This is not a work or an act you and I can do by ourselves, but it requires the strength and the mighty work of God to enable us to mature into the things of God. Verse 2, as we looked into verse 2, it talks about how grace and mercy is multiplied. So as we step in towards growing in the Lord and deepening our experience of Him, the verse says more and more grace and peace will be multiplied, which means the measure of favor and mercy to grow will increase for us exponentially. The source of grace and peace is not in our doing, but it is in God's bountiful desire that we build that intimacy and maturity in our relationship with God. This kind of grace and peace will come only through the knowledge of God. The third verse talks about how His divine power has given us all things. His divine power has given to us all things. The verse 3 says we are strengthened by Christ's power. He is the one who gives us the ability to grow spiritually. This is reiterated in Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20 that it says, it is only through the mighty power we are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or even think. In verse 3, it also talks about how His divine power has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. Peter emphasizes this particular kind of life. He talks about life and godliness. So what does he mean? Life, meaning that all we need in the here and now. And godliness, which simply means a life that is centered on God. A life that chooses to grow more and reflect Jesus. In Jesus, you will find everything you need, a life that flows out of passion for God. The life that He's talking about is not an artificial one, not one that conforms to certain religious expectations or a one that tries to make you a good person, but it is a life that is energized by the power of God and everything that you need to build yourself in Him. So the position that we have and the privilege that are ours in Christ Jesus and all that we will need to live a godly life is given to us as a free gift of God's grace because of His sacrificial work at Calvary. So as His children, we are called to live a life of godliness, to live our life dependent on God. So when we become a child of God, we are given all that we need in Christ to become a spiritually maturing believer. Now God does the changing. He will conform each one of us into the image of Jesus Christ as we surrender to His word and to the Holy Spirit. Let us pray together. Father God, we thank You because You are the source of everything that You want to develop in us. Thank You because You give us the grace and peace. You multiply it for us and You give us the power even as we focus on things for this life and for godliness. We pray that Your Holy Spirit would empower us, would move us into growing into deeper and greater levels in our knowledge of You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.